Let's use ScanUS framing mode to zoom in on an area containing the villages, which is one of the faster growing areas in the past few years. And if we go and choose tour mode, we can see that the villages down here is about, from Jacksonville, if you go this way, 97 plus 61, it's about 150 miles from Jacksonville. And if we click on the villages, we get a little context menu. We can select the villages and use this shortcut up here to create a new study area that's centered right on the villages. And we can adjust our map a little bit using the pan and just pan the villages over so that we have room for some other stuff that's going to appear. And if we look at this road that's going through here, this intersection might not be a bad place to have a business location. So we will go over to edit mode and choose edit areas. And when we choose edit areas, we're going to drop in a trade area. We'll call that the villages trade area and give it a 135-mile ring. And now, anywhere we click in the map, it's going to drop down a ring of that size. So if we click right here, this will pop up, and we'll call this Dock in a Box. And it puts a layer right there. And we can see by choosing Quick Look from the data menu, which brings up the demographic data, that that area has got about 74,000 people, 40,000 households, and various demographic characteristics. We're interested in taking a more articulated look at the vicinity. So if we bring up the Map Layers dialog and activate microgrids, then we can go to the group mode and choose group by radius. And now if we just draw out from the center of where we put our location, our dock in the box store, we can go out, let's go out a little farther so we can get the vicinity of our initial ring and see what we might be missing. And we'll call this Villages Vicinity. And click OK. And this grouping, is, as you can see, is a little bit more people in it. And the reason we're doing this grouping is as a filter so that we can just check objects and check groups and assign a value to those grids. So we go to Classify by Value and choose Objects and Check Groups. And here's the group that we just made, Villages Vicinity, and you can see it's got, if we choose that, this has got 753 microgrids in it. And now, if we click Next, then we can choose the variable that we want to use. Of course, in order to do that, we'll have to choose a variable, so I'll just scroll down here to Median Household Income. That's a pretty good one. And as soon as you click that, here it pops that up, and we'll call this Villages Median Household Income, and click Assign. And you can see these higher income households over here are farther away from our proposed intersection location. We also do Classify by Value on a different demographic variable. So here, I'll do the same thing again. Villages, vicinity. Here we're going to choose from a different database, the Business Summer database, because it has the number of employees in an area. And we're going to choose a different color here, different color scheme. And let's change this value here to 10, so that we want to see only those grids which have 10 or more employees working in the grid. And we'll just eliminate this color entirely. That won't even be colored in to distract us. And we'll call this villages and click assign. So here you can see right along this highway there are quite a few employees. There are some grids that have over 300 employees. There are probably some shopping centers out there. So it looks like this might be more appropriate for a luncheon establishment than a dock-in-the-box ER locale. So let's change the name of that object. So we'll click here, choose our ring, and then if we go over back over to the edit mode, edit areas, we'll be able to right-click and select this and change the area properties so that it will have a different name. So instead of dock in the box, we'll call this Instant Bite of BLT Sandwich! Exclamation point. And that'll change the name of that to be maybe more appropriate to the locale instead of being far away from the people way over in the western side of the villages. It'll be close to the people who are looking for a quick bite of BLT for lunch. Now, part of the point of having these groupings is that you can go back and forth between them and take a look at them. But the rings are filled with data as well. So if you choose this this outer ring and look at the ring using Quick Look, you can see the number of people in this ring, and that may meet a criterion that you're looking for citing a restaurant. Here you can see the 5-mile ring and the 3-mile ring and the 1-mile ring. And but you can also do other kinds of thematics on the microgrid layer using a capability called data layers. So let's take a look at data layers. Form a data layer, you need to be on the layer that you're going to do the data layer. And I'm going to change back to microgrids. And also I think I'll zoom in a little bit on this area using my mouse wheel to zoom in so you can get a good look at what's going to happen here. And then from the data menu, just choose Create Data Layer. So I'm just going to choose one variable. And the variable that I'm going to pick first is age related. So I'm going to go down here and say the population, the percent of the population over 65. And it says, please specify the objects to include in the data presentation. Well, that is a good piece of advice. And so I can either choose all the objects in the map or just the objects in the selected group. And there are a lot of groups to pick from. So I am going to pick all objects in map because it's not that many grids and maybe it'll tell us something interesting. And percent age, 65 years of 16 pop, here it is. And again, I think I'm going to pick a different color scheme to choose from. I'm going to pick this purple. I'll go with the purple. And this will tell us the percentage of people over 65 divided into five cuts, 80% over, 60% over, and so forth. And I'll just choose apply, and that will color in the map. And Maybe I need to zoom back out. You can see that there's a fairly high concentration of people over 65 in this area of the villages, in these grids. But how many people are actually in each grid? Well, that's a good question. One way of finding out is to select a grid and just, so click on a grid here and select it and look at it in Quick Look, and that's that changing to the individual mode of Quick Look, and that could take a while looking at the grids. But there's another thematic that we can use, another type of data layer, which I'll do now. Create data layer, single variable, and here we'll do all objects and map. Here we can pick the proportional marker, and I'm going to pick the proportional marker and choose households. And this will tell us how many households there are in each grid. And it's very fun. You can choose what kind of marker shape here if you want to do a circle, a square, or a triangle. I'm just going to stick with the default one, and you can make the minimum size is going to be this, and the maximum marker size, you have some control over. So I'm going to go, and these are grids, so I'm just going to leave it pretty small. And you can make it transparent or not, and I'm not going to do any of that. I'm just going to say apply, and this will put in a household size marker for each of these grids. So you can see, for example, looking in this area, which we know is a high concentration of people over 65, these particular grids don't have as many people. And down here, the grids are large, right around the instant bite of BLT sandwich. They're large, but they're not particularly old. So that looks like if we could put a if we could go up the road a little bit and cite our instant bite of BLT sandwich up here, this would probably be a better place to put a restaurant. So that is CanUS data layers and classify by value that you can use to get a really good detailed view of a trade area that you're thinking of looking at, that it will give you more information than just doing a quick look and looking at a 3 mile ring. You can really see where the population is distributed.